And we're back.
In a small shrine in Asakusa. It's been almost a year, but that naughty granddaughter of mine still hasn't come home. I thought she'd come crawling back to me after a few weeks, begging for forgiveness, but she hasn't contacted me once. She hasn't written me any letters, or rang me on the phone, or come to see me. She hasn't tried to contact her aunt either. Sakuraku's worried, too. I wonder if she's alright on her own. For all I know, she could be dead. This has gone on long enough. She's an ill-mannered girl, but she's still my family. She might be an adult now, but she's old enough to make her own decisions. But I promised her parents that I'd keep an eye on her. She's always been such a flighty, irresponsible girl. I'm not there to guide her. She'll get herself in all kinds of mischief. Oh, Suikiko, you knock my naughty, poorly behaved Suikiko. When are you going to come home? You continue to defy your grandmother? I don't know if I'll ever be able to forgive you. Time flies by even faster than the blink of an eye. Each minute becomes an hour, each hour a day, and each day a week, and I push myself harder than I ever have before. I buy myself a new laptop, then I hold up in my room for hours on end, typing and deleting and retyping words until my head spins. I've rewritten these scenes so many times I can't tell if they're good or not anymore. In the end, I guess it doesn't matter. I just finished Mikame's two scripts. Ah, if I don't finish the writing, Suki can't finish the last of the CGs, and Clover can't finish the last of the music. I don't want to slow everyone down. I need to push myself. And that's exactly what I do. I write and I write and I write until my fingers feel numb from striking the keys of my laptop. And so, with less than a fortnight before the manga market. Thank goodness. I fall down against my bed with a flop, springs creaking beneath my dead weight. 3. Who knew writing could take so much out of a girl? I'm worn out, but I'm glad I've finally done it. The script for Mikame 2 is officially done. It's one obstacle out of the way, at least. My biggest challenge still awaits me. We'll be going to the manga market soon. Be there for 3 days and I'll bet I'll be really busy. Manga market's always in the height of summer and the convention hall will be packed with sweaty bodies. It'll be too hot and no amount of AC will help cool me down. Sounds like hell. I know I'll hate every single second of it. I'm starting to shake just thinking about it, but I can't back down now. I've come too far. Oh, 4. I'll be with Clover and Sugi, so it should be fine. I'll be fine. I'll be fine, I'll be fine, I'll be fine. No matter how many times I repeat this mantra under my breath, I can't quite bring myself to believe it. 2 weeks later. Alright, we're finally awake. Let's get down to business, everyone. We need to set up our table. So that's what you're going with, huh? Alright. Right. I guess if you're selling the sex game, that's what you do. It's Thursday evening. The convention itself doesn't start until tomorrow, but there are still a large number of people in the convention center setting up the tables. Loud chatter, footsteps, and squeaking tables legs. It goes across the room. The din is so cacophonous it's enough to put me on edge. Suki and Clover are already starting to work on our booth, but I'm frozen in spot. It's so hectic I can hardly hear myself think. Manga market was busy last year, and I think it's even more crowded now. There are hundreds, seemingly thousands of tables being set up, all devoted to different things. Manga, anime, games, music, merchandise. There's so much going on, I can't take it all in. Excuse me, young miss. A man walks past me holding a stack of posters in his arms. His elbow brushes mine and I almost jump a foot in the air like a startled cat. Nyaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaa that. Hope I didn't hurt you. It's all right. Don't worry about me. I should have been more careful. I'm very sorry for getting in your way. I bow hurriedly and take a few steps back. I want to extricate myself from this awkward situation. Hey, watch where you're going, you Nimrod. You almost made me drop these chairs. Well, I'm sorry. I spring back, alarmed, my face beet red. In my attempts to extricate myself from this awkward situation, I stumble upon literally another. Like the first man I bumped into, this one's very tall, broad-shouldered, with bulging muscles. He's so ripped, he could probably tear me apart like a piece of tissue paper. What in the world have I gotten myself into? Did you just bump into the cast of Street Fighter or something? You would be sorry if these chairs had fallen on you. They're heavy, you know. You ought to be more careful, you stupid kid. Manga artists isn't all fun and games, you know. Some of us have our whole livelihoods riding on this event. I'm sorry. I really am sorry. I bow over until I feel dizzy. At least my supplications are enough to placate this man because he snorts and walks off mumbling under his breath. What a loser. Kids today, they're so careless. I bet that girl can't tell her ass apart from her elbow. What's she doing here, of all places? If she takes the manga market lightly, she'll get swept away by the tide. Fucking Bush League shit, dude. Here you go. The manga market's not a fucking game, kid. Swept away? No way. Mind nothing more than a piece of driftwood? You are gonna be eaten alive at the manga market, kid. You're gonna crash and burn. I'm not careful. I might die. I'll die. Hey, Nekohime, what's wrong with you? Your face is so pale. And you're not coming down with something, are you? Oh, no. I'm fine. Really, I'm fine. You don't look fine to me. Come on, Nekohime. You can't lie to me. I'm your girlfriend. I can see through you just like that. She snaps her fingers, and half the population of the universe dies. So what's up? Did something happen? No, not really. It's not that important, but that guy. I glance at the man I bumped into earlier. He's busy setting up a table not too far from ours, his forearms bulging alarmingly as he sets the chairs down. Oh, that muscle man? Did you get into a fight with him or something? No, of course not. I mean, not intentionally. No, what's going on? Did Nekohime get into a fight? It wasn't like a physical fight or anything. I was just spacing out, and then I jostled that guy. He got kind of annoyed. Did he shout at you? Be a bit, but alright, that does it. Nobody shouts at my cute, lovely Nekohime and lives to tell the tale. I'm gonna go give the... I read that wrong. I'm gonna go jerk him off. I'm gonna go give the jerk the scolding of a lifetime. No, Clover, wait, don't do that. Why not? I don't want you to get in trouble, not on my behalf. Don't worry about it. I used to work in an elementary school, remember? I'm used to punishing naughty kids who misbehave. That guy might be all muscle, but he's no match for me. I've broken up hundreds of fights before. But he's not a child. He's a fully grown man. With fully grown muscles, and you taught 7-year-olds. Oh, you'd be surprised at how devious 7-year-olds can be, my sweet, innocent Nekohime. Compared to that jerk Shota who liked to stick pins on my desk every morning, this guy's nothing. He's beneath me. I'm gonna get him have it. No, please, don't do it.
Self-voicing enabled.
No.
Self-voicing disabled.
Maybe, but it's not like I deserved it. I'm the one who got in his way, after all. Looks like he's selling stuff at the manga market, too. I don't want to make an enemy out of him. This table's not that far away from ours. I don't think I could deal with him given the stink guy through the whole convention. I'm not a confrontational person. If I ever got my hands on a holy grail, I'd wish for world peace. Clover might love getting into scraps, but this is a fight I'd rather avoid. Can you drop it, Clover, please? I don't want to make a scene. We might get bad publicity, or might even get kicked out. Or you might get the best publicity. Fight the dude. Just throw him in the trash, dude. We worked hard, but let's not make it go to waste. Not over some random NPC like that. What is he, some, like, alt-right, like pole guy? Like, some NPC, like... Doesn't even have a name or a character sprite. It's not worth it. Oh, it was a meta joke. Okay. As much as it pains me to let bullies like that get off scot-free, I guess you have a point. I don't want to start an altercation. Thank goodness. But if that guy gives you any more trouble, just let me know. I'll deal with him just like I dealt with that brat Shota. Now, how'd you deal with him? That is a secret. You knew what I did to him? You might not be able to sleep at night. That bad, huh? Hope you didn't do anything that'd get you arrested. Didn't sneak needles into his school lunches or inject deadly virus into his milk, did you? No way, this isn't a horror story, and I'm not evil. I simply taught him a lesson he'll never forget. For all your grandstanding, I bet you wrote a sternly worded letter to his mother. Huh? How'd you know? The universal truth that teachers don't have any real power. I was a menace to the classroom when I was a kid, and once I put a frog in my teacher's desk... Yeah, okay. And so there. So, we're gonna continue this shit. Some banter. Do the busy work, I'll start putting up the posters. Want to help me arrange the table, Nakahima? Well, I'm with my closest allies, but my stomach won't stop churning. I feel like I've been strapped in on a particularly violent roller coaster, which has no intention of stopping. It's so noisy in the convention hall, I can barely hear myself think. I just want to lie in bed and pull the covers over my head and go to sleep. Sorry to be a burden. Can I take a few seconds out? I think I need to lie down. It'd be more helpful if you could set up our table with me. There's a lot of work to do, and I know I can't handle it all on my own. But you do look pretty pale. I don't want you fainting, so okay. She nods her head judiciously. You can take a quick break, but I expect you to come back here in 20 minutes. I need you to help me and Clover set up this fiddly electronic stuff. And you're so much better with that kind of thing than we are. So we're not that great. Please be back. I'm really bad at... bad at technology. Yeah. This is a critical time for us. We need you to work together if we want Mega Maze 2 to be a success. You have to have more faith in yourself. Will Neko Hime ever have faith in herself and learn how to be confident? Find out on the next episode of Dragon Ball Z. So it's a busy scene. Numerous ants as they spread tablecloths, tack up posters, put in electronics, and fill wall screws, line up merchandise. It's carnage. The convention center is huge, but one tiny microcosm of this living, pulsing entity. I feel like I've been swallowed whole. Miss Goosey. Calm down, Nekohime. You've gotta calm down. You can't afford to fall apart before the events even started. What the world is wrong with you? I'm sitting on a toilet in a small, cramped restroom cubicle. The lights are artificially bright, and they hurt my eyes. I wince, and I... why do I feel so queasy? It's not like I'm actually sick or anything. I'm fine. I should be fine, but... I clap my cheeks with my palms, hoping to revitalize myself, but I don't feel any more energetic than I did before. In fact, I feel even worse. I need to get over this. I can't let Clover and Suki down. They're both relying on me, but though I know I shouldn't, I reach into a pocket of my skirt and I draw out my cell phone and I turn it on. A cute jingle plays, and then my screen lights up. I open my internet browser and then begin to type with trembling fingers. Gamid Reviews. I haven't read the reviews for the first Mikome visual novel in a long time, and here I am at Manga Market, getting inside your own head. It suddenly feels incredibly important that I know what everyone's saying. It hasn't gotten any more negative attention, has it? Hope not. Review seems pretty positive, at least, but this only one person's opinion. What about all the... What about the one negative one that holds any sort of weight? I look at more reviews more and more. The further I dig into the annals of the internet, the more bile I dredge up, kind of like diving headfirst into a sewer. Some of the reviews are positive, but others, the art's nice, but the writer's a total hack. My 5-year-old cousin can write more erotic scenes than this, lol. How old are the girls in this game? They look suspiciously young, don't you think? Visual novels aren't even real games. They say on their website that all the staff behind this game are women. Yeah, right. Oh, no. little back and forth trying to steady myself. I shouldn't be reading these reviews. I'm being ridiculous. This is why Clover and Super said stop it. Group said on their blog that they're going to be at Manga. Maybe we should pay them a visit. I'll tell exactly what we think of their so-called story. No way, this can't be real. They don't mean that, do they? I don't know if I'll be able to cope with that. My self-esteem is already dangerously low. If I met with any of these people face to face, I'm too fragile. Why did I ever think I could write visual novels for a living? I was just setting myself up for failure. The world's way too unforgiving. I can't stand up to it on my own. Well, from my mental breakdown to the restroom, I return to the... Just like that. When I get back, most people have already finished setting up. I force myself to smile, but that doesn't stop Suki and Clover for shooting me an anxious looks. Hey, Nekohime, are you alright? You look paler than ever. Your skin's just like paper. Don't worry about it. I'm fine, really. Are you sure? You don't look fine. Yes, I am. I've never been better. Well, let me start getting our table set up. Three of us work for the next hour, retrieving things from our car and arranging our tables until everything looks perfect. When Suki's finally satisfied, we retreat from the convention center and head to our hotel. The hotel Suki booked is pretty close to the convention center, and it's fancy too. Find us a nice place to stay, but I had no idea it'd be this luxurious. Our room's awesome. The bed looks so soft. The TV's huge. We even have our own balcony. Look at that amazing view. And then in the bathroom, I can't believe it. There isn't a bidet, is there? No, it's even better than that. It's a hot tub. A real hot tub. It looks like it has jets and all sorts of shit. So... What do you mean, so? You don't have any sense of adventure? I've always wanted to go soak in a hot tub. Can you help me? We haven't had a compulsory sex scene in a while, so let's start one of those. I think Suki was expecting this embrace because she doesn't stumble. Instead, she smiles and pats the top of Clover's head. No problem. I'd do anything to make the hard-working members of my team happy. I am happy. This is like the best. There's a load of fancy soaps and shampoos in the bathroom and white fluffy towels. The fridge is full of champagne and little chocolates. We're living the dream. I feel like a celebrity. Clover extricates herself from Suki and flops down on the bed, laughing all the while. This must be what heaven feels like. I'm so happy. I could die right now. Looks so cheery, and I envy her. I wish my worries could be more alleviated by a hot tub and a few bottles of expensive champagne that they're going to charge you like $300 for if you open. Well, Clover's made her feelings about this room quite apparent. What about you? Do you like the hotel I booked, Nekohime? Well, I looked out the window. We're very high up. I think we're on the 15th floor, and the city spread out before me. Looks like a diorama. I can see cars flitting? I haven't heard that word before either. I'm illiterate. Nothing more than the golden spots of light. It's a pretty view, but wasn't this place expensive, Suki? It was a little pricey, yeah, but we can afford it. We've sold a lot of copies of Mika Made, so I figured we could splooge a bit. Mika Made will sell even better than the first one, and then we'll be super rich. That's a nice thought, but isn't merging on something like this a bit irresponsible? There's no guarantee that Mika Made 2 will do this well. Equals always ship less copies than their first installment of any series. That's not always true. New to be invested when they haven't read the first part. They don't want us to fritter away our savings recklessly. We really should have booked somewhere cheaper. Oh, don't be so negative. We worked hard this last year. It's way longer than the first part. It has more art and music. People will love it. There are no buts. Hey, I'm playing Sakura Gamer 2. I have not played Sakura Gamer 1. So, calm down. The convention will be pretty busy. It'll be nice to rest and relax in a huge fancy room like this at the end of the day. Now shut up and enjoy yourself. That's an order. But, yeah, you can't turn it off like a light switch. I'm not a Mormon. Got anxiety. Just classic anxiety. Want to go in the hot tub? Let's do that. Let's do the hot tub thing. That's what we're here for. I don't know if I can relax. Alright. So what are we doing? Eating chocolate suzuki? Going on a walk on my own? Or getting in the hot tub? Whoa, 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 whoa! Spring break! Etc. Whoa. So full of suds. This really hits the spot. Doesn't the warm water feel great? Yes, it does feel kind of nice, yeah? Just kind of nice? Raises an eyebrow. You've got to learn to be more positive, Nekahime. I know, I really am trying, but I look down at my knees. They protrude from the bubbling surface of the water like two albino islands. I've never had the healthiest complexion, but since I quit my old job to be a full-time visual novel writer, I'm paler than ever before. I think I've lost a little bit of weight, too. I look skinnier than ever before. Word for them, I'd go days without speaking to another human being besides board clerks at convenience stores, and it's not like you can really have conversations with them. I'm sorry if I'm spoiling things, Clover. I'm just a little out of it. You're not spoiling anything, silly Nekahime. I'm just glad to have you here. You are? Yeah, haven't I told you enough times? Amber winds an arm around my shoulder and pulls me close against her. I like you a lot, Nekahime. Suki's my friend, and you're my girlfriend, and I ain't gonna let you suffer on your own. Got your back, I promise. I want to believe her, but last time you tried to console me, you broke my laptop. Oh, you gotta bring that up. Taira no Kyomi, he's a well-known military leader from the Heian period. Didn't you learn about him at school? Well, maybe, but you know how I am with Japanese history. It's in one year and out the other, unless I'm playing 99 Nights 2. I really couldn't care less about a bunch of boring old samurai. I mean, they're all dead now. Because of the Gatling gun.
Self-voicing enabled. Self-voicing disabled.
What do you care about then? Cute girls, of course. That's why I like you so much, Nekuhime. You have more honor than any samurai, and I would be subservient to you as a daimyo any day. But I'm not cute. Yes, you are cute. You're totally cute. Clover inches even closer to me. If such a thing's possible, her breasts slick with water slide against my arm. I can feel her hardened nipples against my skin, and I shiver. We're so close to spring break! A Sakura gamer too! Our thighs press together. There isn't an inch of space between us. So why don't you open up and tell me what's wrong? Can't cheer you up if I don't know what the problem is. That is, I bite my lower lip and glance away guiltily. I don't want to drag you down into my own misery. That wouldn't be fair. You wouldn't drag me down. If anything, I'll be the one to raise you up. How can you be so certain? That's obvious. Pokes the tip of my nose with her index with a bright smile on her face. I'm the cheery kind of gal. I don't succumb to despair. If my skin was that thin, I never would have been able to hack it as a teacher for so long. Suppose you have a point? Why don't you talk to me? We're all alone now and there's nobody to intrude. You don't have to feel self-conscious when we're together. I care about you and I won't judge you no matter what you have to say. Are you sure? I'm sure. Well then, this will probably sound stupid, but look down at my depressingly pale knees. I started to read a few reviews of Makemade online. Oh no, Nekahime! Wags a finger in my face like a disgruntled teacher might. I've been through this before. You said you wouldn't read those reviews anymore. Not after they upset you so much. Why are you putting yourself through this unnecessary stress? There's actually a word for this. It's like called like emotional self-harm or something like that. And like, it's very real. It's like seeking out things that you know will hurt you because, just because. I know, I was being stupid. I shouldn't have looked, but curiosity got the better of me. I figured since we're going to sell Mika Made 2 tomorrow, I should see what people were saying about the first game. And I take it they weren't positive things. Some of the reviews were, but you're a gloomy girl and you never take those comments to heart. That's right, I couldn't believe all the nice comments. But when it came to the nasty ones, you let them get under your skin. It's not a case of letting. I don't want to get that upset either, but I can't help myself. Some of the comments were really harsh. Someone said I was a loser and a creep and a useless virgin. They were so mean. Ugh, those assholes. That really is too much. That might be a bit awkward, but you're not a loser or a creep. And as for the virgin part... You and I both know that isn't true, do we? I guess. I dipped my head. Face burning bright red. Clover's right on that squirrel. I had fuck with her. A lot. You know, I was giving that a little thought lately. What? Our sex life. Ah, here it goes. Spring break 2020. Licks her lip, then her mouth widens inches from my ear. Clover whispers hotly. It's been a while since I could hold my head up since we last had sex, hasn't it? Why don't we rectify that? You look so good. All that damp, wet, and naked. I can hardly contain myself. You're such a pervert. Says the one who writes all the sex scenes for our games. But last time, visual novels aren't games, and it's not like I write those sex scenes because I want to. I'm just helping you out. I'm not a pervert. You say, but I think you might be a little perverse deep down. Shut up. I turn my head away, arms folded. I want to look cool and aloof, but my stupid cheeks won't stop blushing. It's one of the problems with having pale skin. I go red way too easily. At least Clover seems to have relented in her teasing, for now at least, because the coy grin fades from her face. That's why you've been acting down tonight, Nekohime, those comments online? Partially, but that's not all. Somebody said they checked our blog and they know we'll be at Manga Market this week, and they said they were going to stop by our table so they can insult us to our faces. I'd like to see them try. I bet they were just talking a bit. I bet they'll actually do that. How can you be so sure? It's common sense. But you had more. People who write negative comments online can only do those from the safety of the room, behind the screens. Alright. So more talk of this. Internet criticism talk. Everything's gonna be fine. Nobody wants to make you cry, but what if they do? Then I'll protect you. Alright. Finally, I can breathe. Are you alright? Did that cheer you up? Yeah, I think it did. Thanks. I'm on my own. It's easy to get sucked into a spiral of depression, but you always know how to lift my spirits, especially when you... He isn't spilling massage oil all over my laptop. Thank you, Clover. I appreciate it. It's no problem. Let me live with you for years, so I figured I should return the favor. I know I annoy you sometimes, Nekohime, and it's not always the easiest person to live with. At least I can be a good partner. You're the best in the world. Meanwhile... It really is late. I should probably turn in soon, but... Oh, Suiko... I wonder what you're doing right now. Are you looking at the same starry sky as me? If only you'd let me know what you're doing. You can't survive without me. You're far too flighty. You need me there so I can shape you into a proper adult. But you betrayed me. You betrayed our family. I wish I could forgive you for that, but you hurt me far too deeply. If I ever track you down... No, when I track you down, I'll make you pay. I'll drag you back home by the hair if I have to, and I'll make you... kowtow before me until the skin of your palms and your forehead begin to wear away. It's what you deserve, my dear granddaughter. After all, you broke my poor old heart. Next day. Everything feels great. Everything is great. Yeah, let's... Oh, no. I'm getting dressed. Please don't walk in on me. So peaceful. So. Alright. Ah, you like the first Mega Man? Thank you very much. So you want to buy 3 copies, one for your collection? Well, that's just fine. You really think that music's good? Aw, shucks, you're too kind. Merchandise, huh? We could make some keychains in the future, maybe posters? Here you go, sir. Please enjoy the game. Now, it's not that great, but thanks. I worked really hard on it. If you compliment me too much, my face is going to go red. So she's not getting any compliments for it. But I think that's kind of how that goes a lot. Oftentimes, people don't compliment the writing. Like, actors get a lot of, like, attention with that. I'm crawling with people, scuttling here and there like ants, and a totally high concentration of damp, sweaty bodies. Again with the damp, sweaty bodies. The convention is large, but it's practically bursting at the seams. Ripple through the air like an electronic current. Money changes hands, customers bow as they accept their long-awaited products. Anime dances through the air, and so does the heavy, pungent smell of sweat. It's unpleasantly hot, and my stares stick into my cheeks and the back of my neck. Let's see. I'm just thinking of still spiraling. Excuse me, miss. You have to serve these customers with a warm smile. I can't afford to cower back, shrinking in fear. Miss, excuse me. This is not a good time to have a panic attack. There's never a good time to have a panic attack, but now would be a... Can I buy this game? Oh, I'm sorry. I hope I didn't keep you waiting. Oh, not at all. I've just been standing here for like 5 minutes. Don't mind me. It's not like I'm a paying customer or anything. The vitriol in his voice made me shudder. I know it's my job to keep the line flowing smoothly, but it doesn't have to be so snippy about it. Manga market's crowded this year, you know. Dozens of stalls I want to check out. If I'm not fast, everything I want will be sold out. I can't afford to wait here too long. Right. That's right. Sorry. Thank you for your support. I bow to the man humbly, and then take its shiny case from his hands. Let's wrap that for you. It'll be tell the man the price, and he digs in his pocket and hands me a few crumpled notes. Then we hand it back with the game in it. Here you go. If you enjoy it. Yeah, whatever. Thanks. The man doesn't wait for me to reply. He snatches the bag from my shaking hand and stalks off. Hope I didn't piss him off too much. Why am I so socially incompetent? I need to get my act together so I can keep ruining things for Clover. I can't keep ruining things for Clover and Sugi. I've got to work harder. It's me. I'm here to buy Mikume 2. Oh yes, you come to the right table. Let me wrap that copy up for you. The day continues. Everything's fine. Struggling. Dude, it never seems to be good enough. I can't believe it. You're so cute. Another customer is standing before the table. He doesn't look bored and mildly irritating, but some of the other customers I've had the pleasure of serving, he looks enthused, a bright smile on his face. In fact, he looks generally overjoyed to meet me. In a way, that's even more terrifying than the cold, hard stares I received earlier. At least I didn't need to worry about letting those people down. Why is this guy staring at me like that? You're not really involved in Mikumade, are you? Yes, that's right, I'm the writer, actually, and the coder. The writer? So you wrote all those steamy sex scenes? I imagine he's doing, like, the quagmire as he does it. Yeah, that's right, The sex scenes weren't really that steamy, were they? They were. They totally were. Especially the one scene where all the... with all the melted... another misread. With all the methed up chocolate. It was all incredibly erotic. I never knew a girl was capable of writing stuff like that. I thought a guy had written the script for sure, but Nekohime seemed like a weirdly cute name for a man. And I thought you might be a feminine man, but... looks like you really are a girl. You're a cute girl. You're cute and lewd. There's no better combination. Being a real creep. This feels like a nightmare. At least I'm not a naked. That's something, I guess. You're not cute, but you are. You're adorable. Your eyes are so big. You look like an angel. Your eyes are so big. I can't believe a girl like you would just write Roch Sessera. Those slender, delicate fingers of yours really know their way around a keyboard. I did used to be a computer repair, and now you're pairing the hearts of men like me. Reading porn written by a lovely young flower in full bloom. There's no medicine more potent. I always thought Mika made was a special game, and now it's worth so much more in my heart. Can I touch you? Your skin looks so soft. I want to see how it feels. Sorry, but I don't really like being touched by strangers. Ah, so you're shy too? How adorable. That makes you even more lovely. Now on, you're my number one waifu, Nekohime. Well, I'm not your wife. I don't even know you. I'm going to say that you don't know me when I've jacked off to your writing more times than I can count. That's not a strong bond. I don't know what is. Too much information. I knew when I agreed to write porn game, people would jack off to my stories, but it's not like I want to be told that to my face. This guy, who's a complete stranger, wants to touch me with the same hands he used to touch himself? It's not fair. Why can't I have a cute, big-boobed, glasses-wearing girlfriend to write porn for me? Oh my god. DateNight2020 has been a ride. I'm gonna finish this scene out, and then we'll close the chapter of DateNight2020. I don't know how much more of this I can do. If I had my friends to bounce back and forth from, that would be one thing, because we'd be suffering together. But I'm suffering on my own. And... woof. Hands are getting closer any second now. He's going to run them through my hair and across my cheek. I don't want that. I want this guy to leave me alone, but it's not like I can push him away. That'd be bad for business. I don't want to cause a scandal. Suki and Clover and I worked hard on this game. I can't throw out all of our efforts. Perhaps I'll just have to grin and bear it. Need to try and smile. Whoa, buddy, what you think you're doing? Who are you? I'm Clover, the composer for Miko Maid, and also Nekohime's dear companion. I'm glad you think my colleague is so cute, but you can't touch her. She isn't a doll, you know. That's right, Nekohime is our precious writer, and she belongs to us. Ah, you girls. The customer looks between Clover and Sugi for a minute. I worry he's going to lose his temper, but you're all cute too. I can't believe it. I read on your website you were all women, but I didn't really believe it. I thought it was some publicity thing, but I guess it is true. If you girls all create lewd stories about lesbian romance, could it be? Are you all going out with each other? That's right, as you can see. Oh, okay. Some of that. Okay. He's out in cups of breasts, her eyes glittering wickedly. We're all madly in love. Suki? Try to squirm free from her touch, embarrassed. Being groped in private's one thing. Yeah, that's super not cool. This is embarrassing. Oh, but you usually love it when I touch you like this, darling. Suki pinches my nipples beneath the fabric of my shirt and I squirm. Suki? Yeah, you sound so cute when you moan like that. I'm not moaning. Then what about now? She nibbles the shell of my ear with her teeth. Yeah, you're definitely moaning now. The chest is rising and falling so goddamn much, and your face is all red. God damn it. I don't want to do this. I never asked for this. I thought Sakura Gamer would be way... okay, this was too dumb, but it was, like, not the right kind of too dumb. This is, like, the... You really are cute, Nekohime. You're my own adorable kitty. Suki licks my ear with increasing intensity while I gasp. My head is spinning. For some reason, my heart won't stop pounding. There, you see. Suki looks back at the customer, challenging grin on her lips. My cute pet, and I love her a lot. I'm sorry, I can't touch it. I see. That does make sense. It makes perfect sense. Does it? It doesn't make much sense to me, but what do I know? My legs feel so weak and they can hardly support my own weight. My head is spinning. I'm very sorry for my poor conduct. If I had known Nekohima was in a committed relationship with another cute girl, I wouldn't have tried to touch her. Now I see the error of my ways. I hope you can forgive me. He bows so deeply that his forehead smacks against our table with a loud thud. If people weren't staring at us before, they definitely are now. It's one thing for a man like me to appreciate a cute lesbian's love story when it's in a visual novel, but it's quite another for me to come to an actual flesh and blood woman who adore one another. I hope you forgive me for trying to insert myself into your lily garden. It's alright, if you find any weeds, we just need to prune them. That's right, that's exactly right. Compared to the radiance of your pure romance, I am nothing but a weed. I'm not worthy to witness such a sight like this. I hate this! Now, and thanks for my actions, please let me buy 5 copies of Mikamate 2. But of course. And she removes her hands from my breast and shoots the customer a winning smile. Rattles off an extortionate price that's double what we charge for our other customers, but that man doesn't blink an eyelid. He reaches into his wallet and, swayed by the scene of pure love that was fortunate enough to witness, to his hands all over his money without comment. Yuki wraps 5 copies of Mechamate into a cellophane wrapper, then hands them to the man. Here you go. It's a pleasure doing business with you. Oh no, the pleasure was all mine. I'll never forget this day, not for as long as I live. Thank you for letting me witness something so wonderful. I really have been blessed. I'll tell all of my friends buy lots of copies, and you'll all get rich. Then he walks off. It's one customer, but there's still a huge line queuing up. The line's got even bigger. Thank you for tuning in to Date Night 2020. I hope you had as good a time as I had, because it was amazing. It was incredible. And now that date night's over, once we find a day where we can all get together, we're gonna get back to streaming Zelda. Look forward to that. Bye.